do not take the oil. The woman wants the offer to oil the jars with the ashes. The bride was a long time. They all became pregnant and fell to the ground. At midnight, the bride rang out, "Here's the bridegroom. Come out to meet him." Then all the virgins woke up. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, our lamps are going out." "No," they replied, "there may not be enough for both of us and him." Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourselves. But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the bridegroom arrived. The virgins who were ready went to the wedding. The door was shut. Later, the others also said, "Lord, Lord," they said, "open the door for us." But they replied, "Should we have time? I don't know. Therefore, keep watch. Your sin did not make you dead or die." This is a word from the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. The Lord, that word of God, I Something about the wind. a word lacking greatness, or the life of greatness. It is not to us, because it's not a victory. But he said at the beginning of this parable, the kingdom of God is like 10 virgins that went out to be a bridegroom. Our expectation is that all we welcome, but we need to tell them something different is going on here. That we all need to make our own preparations to do the best we can do. We need people to be ready, even if it's a long wait. And the truth is, we can start waiting. 2,000 plus years is a long we've grown accustomed to our comforts and comforts. But still, we must make sure that we are ready to take the message of God. In Matthew 17, it says this: not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. What Jesus is doing is reminding us is we cannot give lip service to our faith when Jesus appears while we go through his emotions, simply appearing to be a Christian. It may come as a surprise, the illness, but the work and live our lives according to God's principles. Unfortunately, this is not difficult. But rather, it's about your relationship with God and the world around you. It's how you live your life outside of these four walls and outside of time of worship. How do we do that? We simply live the gospel. We share the good news of Jesus Christ. We welcome strangers. We minister to the children of sin. We make disciples of the lost. The Lord God makes it easy to be faithful. He pleases us in all things. Micah 6:8 tells us exactly what it is. It's not hard, and it's not unbiblical. But rather, it speaks to how we should live a kingdom of faith and how we can make. Micah 6:8 reads, he has told you, O woman, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you but to do justice, to love your enemies, and to work for your neighbor. It's not how we run at all. It is how we remain prepared